Thank you all for being here. I really want to thank the Crocodile, the fabulous soundman Jen, the great staff. They put up with us for 4 days. They've had some really great shows here. Thank you guys. I also want to thank all the bands who played tonight. Sean Nelson in particular, who's helped put this all together. Sean and I have a secret history, which I won't divulge on stage. But he did live with me at one point, so there are stories. Probably from his end, not mine. Also, I want to thank our volunteers. Our volunteers are fabulous. Without you guys, Noble of Nine is nothing. It's been a crazy 4 days. I don't know if you know all that we've been doing all over town, but it's been fabulous. It's been fun. This is it. We've raised a ton of money for one purpose and one purpose only. That's regime change at home. When we started in January, it was a small idea, and we came around the idea that music does have the power to change things, and that what we wanted to change most was our fucking president. So, to that end, we've raised a lot of money. We're going to get that message out nationwide through matching grants to progressive organizations like Election Watch and MoveOn.org. We're giving money to the DNC targeted to get people in your age group in states like Ohio and Florida to the polls. And the most important thing, though, is that all of you do something on November 2nd. And what's that? And and unlike some other organizations, it's not just okay to vote, you gotta vote against Bush. Poll after poll in this country says that the majority of Americans are opposed to the war in Iraq. They want equal protection under the law for people regardless of race, gender, or sexual orientation. They believe in a woman's right to choose. We should expect that our representative government represents us. So make it happen on November 2nd. Take 10 of your friends to the polls. Talk to your Republican parents, friends, till you're blue in the face and make them realize it's time for change. If you're dating a Republican, which I hope you're not, or you're married to one, don't fuck them until they decide they're gonna change their vote. I had this shirt made for last night. I don't know if you can all see this, but this is the best quote ever. It's from Mark Arm from Mudhoney. I will do anything to get that rat fucker out of office. I want you all to do something too. Vote, bug people. You've given money tonight, that's great, but make it happen on November 2nd. Thank you all for being here. Enjoy the rest of the show. Chris Olsen. I will tell the stories when the string inevitably breaks. But first, we're going to play a song by a suspected terrorist. sits in a corner by the door. There must be more I can tell her if she really wants me to help her. I'll do what I can to show her the way, and maybe one day I will free her. Drive to the QFC and buy some orange juice. Do it now. And now he's in charge of defeating the sitting president. Yeah! It might not be a bad time to say thank you to all the other bands one more time. Palomar, all the way from NYC. Little did they know they were getting involved in some kind of pinko steak smashing situation. But involved they are. They're on the FBI's list. So I hope they're not flying anywhere anytime soon. Or any of you. Alright, this song's called Pike Street Park Slope.
Just projecting onto me. Why don't you try LA? Pike Street to Park Slope, Brooklyn. You like something, it's an opinion. But when I like something, it's a manifesto. Pomposity is when you always think you're right. Arrogance is when you know. Maybe we can start a little independent repertory movie house or something. But I think you might be just protecting your investment, or else a signing play. Pike Street to Park Slope, Brooklyn.
Rachel Roman. Welcome to the stage, Aaron Huffman. Mike, welcome. Nice work. Rachel, as you know, is in Sun by Sea. They played a couple songs earlier tonight. Changed a couple of swing voters' minds along the way, undoubtedly. Including Mike's mom. They say if you can reach just one mom. At the risk of playing something new, we're going to play a new song. If that's all right? It's called Wine, Women, and Song.
If you're lucky, you can.
Thank you.
Now, I've heard that Dasani is just old Coke water that they didn't use, but it tastes pretty good. All right, time for some rock and roll.
Yes, it's possible.
one new song. And then the show's gonna start. If your laughing shows up on the bootlegs, I'm gonna be pissed. Thank you. I didn't think- think I could jump up and down for a whole verse. I'm not sure I should have. But I think the bourbon is mixed with the soda water now. And I'm ready to serve cocktails. You'll notice that Mike Welke has left the stage, leaving a vacuum in the drum throne. A vacuum which can only be filled by one man. The man who created it.
Gentlemen.
By moving to Chicago so long ago after we had broken up, and then we got back together and he was in Chicago. But without him, none of these songs could have been written. Yeah, I think that's good. None of the shows we have ever played could have been played. None of the band could have ever been a band. Seattle would not have been the explosion that it was so long ago without one man. One man named Evan Salt. Without whom, none of this were possible. I guess it's as tall as the microphone gets. So Evan happened to be in town, and we happened to be playing a show. The stars aligned. It was an election year, so we figured, what the fuck? We have not really rehearsed, unless you count playing the song 7 or 8 times at soundcheck. This is called Why I'm Lonely. Amsterdam, and he's like, I don't like that. But I would like to do a speedball. That's actually true. We'll be right back. Fright Fest. It was our third appearance there. The first on the Seattle stage. I don't think that's important.
I like to call it the No Restroom Provided stage.
And when there's no restroom provided, you make your own restroom. That's something I learned in the long winters. But playing Fright Fest put me in mind of the fact that it's been a while since we've had what they call in the radio industry a hit. Now, I'm not losing any sleep over it, but we've been hard at work writing songs for the next record, and we think this next one has some real commercial possibilities. Hopefully, our friend and mentor, John Goodmanson, will be able to apply his magic ears and let us know what he thinks at the end. We hope you enjoy it. Let's talk this over. It's not like we're dead. Was it something I did? Was it something I said? Don't leave me hanging in a city so dead. Hanging so high on such a breakable thread. You were everything I thought I knew. Lashes. just gonna settle down and do a song. And I don't think I was the only one in this room who witnessed the rebirth of the Western State Hurricanes tonight. Speaking of fucking hot. Thank you. dozen people there. And I swear to fucking God, there are about 15 people. Including us. And that's why we had Mike Squires and John Roderick in the band. Anyway, Evan and I had gotten really stoned in the hotel room. And we were watching the controversy unfold.
That's all right.